Good afternoon, students. So in this matrix space paper, so we see here one more example. That is the example of a Fréchet space. So this mathematician Fréchet, so who introduced the concept of a matrix space. So we see here this example. Let X be the set of all sequences of complex numbers. So our given set X, this contains all the sequences like xn, yn, and these are the sequences of complex numbers. Means every element of this sequence is a complex number. And here for this set, we have given this function d, and this function is defined as. So this function is defined such that distance between any two elements. Now here the element x and y are the sequences of complex numbers. So this function is defined by distance between xy, that is distance between two sequences xn and yn, which is equal to the summation of this quantity, summation of 1 upon 2 raised to n, and numerator is a mod of the difference between the consecutive terms of a two sequences xn and yn, and denominator is a 1 plus again this same difference. So now here for this function, we have to prove this set X is a matrix space. So to prove this set X is a matrix space, first we have to prove this function D is a matrix on X. So to prove this function is a matrix on X, so we have to prove here the four properties in the definition of matrix. So we try to prove here these four properties one by one. That is your first property. First we want to prove here what? That is distance between any two element of this given set X is greater than or equal to 0. First condition is I want to prove here d of xy is greater than or equal to 0. This first condition, that is a non-negativity. So here this function is defined like this. So here since, that is here summation from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon 2 to the power n into this mod xn minus yn divided by 1 plus mod xn minus yn. So here this, so already we have, so these are the sequences of complex numbers, means here xn, this is a modulus of difference of nth n terms of a sequences. And modulus of, so this is sequence of complex number, this is sequence of complex number, and the difference of modulus of complex number is a non-negative, that is greater than or equal to 0. So mod function is always non-negative. Non-negative means other than negative. Other than negative means either it is 0 or positive. So this mod value is greater than or equal to 0. So numerator is greater than or equal to 0. And further here this quantity in the denominator, this is non-negative, and plus 1 this is positive. So this bracket is a greater than or equal to 0, numerator is greater than equal to 0, and 1 upon 2 raised to n is greater than or equal to 0. So for n is equal to 1 to infinity means, so this is a sum of the non-negative terms. So here just for n is equal to 1, this term is a, so we see here for n is equal to 1, so the first term of this series is a 1 upon n is a 1, 2 to the power 1 means simply 2, mod of x1 minus y1 divided by into bracket 1 plus mod of x1 minus y1. So as we have seen, this is a non-negative term, first term is a non-negative, then for n is equal to 2, so plus next term 1 by 2 to the power 2 mod of x2 minus y2 upon 1 plus mod of x2 minus y2, and plus dash dash dash, this is a sum of the infinite number of terms. So sum of the infinite number of non-negative terms is a greater than or equal to 0. So that's why this is greater than or equal to 0. But here by the definition of this function, this right hand side, and this is nothing but distance between x, y is greater than or equal to 0. So first condition is true for all x is equal to xn and y is equal to the sequence yn, sequence of complex numbers. Because here the elements of this given set X are the sequences of complex numbers. So first condition is here satisfied. So further, second condition we want to prove, that second condition is a, we want to prove distance between xy is equal to 0 if x is equal to y. This second condition I write here in the definition of metric, d of xy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y. We have to prove here this second condition. So here further I have, that is summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by 2 to the power n, numerator is mod xn minus yn upon into bracket 1 plus mod xn minus yn. So here I have, so we neglect this summation. So in this quantity, so when this quantity will be 0, so if the difference of this modulus is 0, either the numerator is 0 or the denominator is 0. So when the numerator is a 0, so if this difference is 0, that is xn minus yn, if xn minus yn is equal to 0, so xn minus yn is equal to 0, when xn minus y, so if xn minus yn is equal to 0, that is if xn is equal to yn. So if xn is equal to yn means, if these two sequences xn and yn are equal, if the two sequences are equal, then this difference is 0, this numerator is 0, then this total quantity is 0. So this is a 0, this summation is a 0, if I double f means if and only if these two sequences are equal, if xn is equal to yn. And here this left hand side, this is nothing but distance between xy, this is 0, if and only if these sequences xn is equal to yn means, so as x is equal to xn and y is equal to yn. So further here, this second condition, that is the symmetry, this second condition is also satisfied. So next I want to prove here symmetry, that is here. So one thing is important, that we have for the real numbers or complex numbers, that this difference mod a minus b is equal to mod of b minus a, this always true. And now here likely I use here, that is here this summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by 2 to the power n, numerator is a mod xn minus yn divided by into bracket 1 plus mod xn minus yn. So this summation is equal to, as we have this difference of mod of xn minus yn, which is equal to mod of yn minus xn. So in place of mod of xn minus yn, I just write here mod of yn minus xn. So this can be written as summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by 2 to the power n. So numerator can be written as just mod yn minus xn. So divided by into bracket 1 plus, again I write this as in place of mod xn minus yn, I write here mod yn minus xn. So now this left hand side, now here left hand side is nothing but I write here by the definition of this function, here difference is between xn minus yn, xn minus yn here means, by the definition this left hand side is nothing but distance between xy, and similarly on the right hand side yn minus xn, here again yn minus xn. So this right hand side is nothing but distance between yx. So this condition, third condition, is also satisfied. Means your symmetry is also satisfied for the element of x with respect to this given function. So now here in this example, so we prove here this last condition in the definition of metric, that is a triangle inequality. So to prove the triangle inequality, so we establish or we obtain one inequality, and we have to use that inequality. First we have to obtain that inequality and then we use it. So let 0 is less than equal to alpha, less than equal to beta. So here means alpha is less than equal to beta. So in this inequality, so if we add and subtract a similar quantity on both sides, then this remains same. That is, we add and we add a quantity alpha into beta on both sides, then it will be remains same. That is alpha plus alpha into beta. So this is similar, beta plus alpha into beta. And just we are adding this on the both the sides. So therefore, left hand side, we take alpha common, alpha into 1 plus beta. This is less than equal to, we take beta common. So beta into 1 plus alpha. So just here we make, so here dividing both sides by 1 plus alpha into 1 plus beta. So we dividing by this product of the this two, multiplication of two brackets on both the sides, then what happens, that alpha into 1 plus beta divided by this, we are dividing by this quantity 1 plus alpha into 1 plus beta, which is less than equal to beta into 1 plus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha into 1 plus beta. So this 1 plus beta, this bracket gets cancelled, and likely here this 1 plus alpha, this bracket gets cancelled, and we have the inequality alpha divided by 1 plus alpha, which is less than equal to beta divided by 1 plus beta. So now we have established here this inequality. So I can give this as inequality number 1. And this inequality we use here further for proving the triangle inequality. And this inequality is true for the numbers like if alpha is less than equal to beta. For alpha is less than equal to beta, but here both are the non-negative. So if both alpha and beta are non-negative, and such that alpha is less than equal to beta, then for these numbers we can take here this inequality. Now I want to use here this inequality, alpha upon 1 plus alpha is less than equal to beta upon 1 plus beta. So now we prove the triangle inequality. So now here we want to prove here triangle inequality, this fourth condition in the definition of metric. So let x is equal to xn, sequence xn, because these are the element of this set x, y is equal to sequence yn of complex numbers, and z is equal to sequence zn. So all these are the three elements of given set x. And now, so we consider this difference mod of xn minus yn. So the difference, modulus of the difference of complex numbers, so this is greater than equal to 0. So as mod xn minus yn, the difference of the modulus of difference of complex numbers is greater than equal to 0. This similar inequality can be written in reverse order, that is, this can be written as 0 is less than equal to, means this is a non-negative, this mod of difference is a non-negative. And we consider, so in this difference we add and subtract zn. So just this difference we add and subtract zn, mod of xn I subtract zn minus zn plus zn. Just in this difference we are adding and subtracting zn and minus this as it is yn. So this difference is a complex number, because these are the sequence of complex number, these terms are complex number, difference between two complex number, and this is a difference between two complex number. Difference between two complex number is a one complex number, and again further this is a difference between two complex number is a one complex number. So for the complex number, we have one property that is here z1, z2. These are any two complex numbers. Then we have this mod of z1 minus z2. Mod of z1 plus z2 is less than equal to mod z1 plus mod z2. So this is one complex number. This is one complex number. Mod of the sum of the two complex number is less than equal to mod of this complex number xn minus zn plus mod of this complex number zn minus yn. So we are using here this modulus property of the complex numbers, and this similar property for the real numbers also. So here, now I have this 0 is less than equal to this difference is less than equal to this mod of xn minus zn plus mod of zn minus yn. So now I want to use here this inequality number 1. So 0 is less than equal to this difference. This modulus, suppose this alpha. So now here we have 0 is less than equal to this difference, less than equal to this plus this. Suppose this is alpha, this modulus is alpha, this modulus is beta, and this modulus is a this combinedly, this total, this is beta. Okay. Alpha is less than equal to beta. Now alpha is this modulus, and beta is this total sum of the two modulus. This is total beta. And for alpha is less than equal to beta, we have alpha upon 1 plus alpha is less than equal to beta upon 1 plus beta. So for this two, this alpha, this total is beta. For this we use here this. Therefore, as alpha and beta are positive, this is positive, this is also positive. And for that we use here this inequality, alpha upon 1 plus alpha. Here alpha is this difference. Therefore, I write here, therefore alpha is this difference, mod of xn minus yn divided by 1 plus alpha. Alpha is this mod, divided by 1 plus mod xn minus yn. This is less than equal to beta. Now beta is this sum of the two modulus, mod of xn minus zn plus mod of zn minus yn divided by, this is beta, beta upon 1 plus beta. 1 plus beta is again this same, xn minus zn plus zn minus yn. So which is equal to, so this is less than equal to, right hand side can be written as, which is equal to, right hand side can be written as, this total denominator, we write this total denominator separately, mod of xn minus zn divided by this denominator 1 plus mod of xn minus zn plus mod of zn minus yn plus, we write denominator for this, again the same denominator for this next, mod zn minus yn divided by 1 plus mod xn minus zn plus mod zn minus yn. So here, so now I just consider this term. I want to consider here this first term on the right hand side. So first term, mod xn minus zn divided by 1 plus mod xn minus zn plus mod zn minus yn. And here this quantity, mod xn minus zn upon 1 plus mod xn minus zn. Now just this is one term and this one term. I am considering this first term on the left hand side. So the what is the relation between this quantity, this one and this quantity? So in numerator is here similar, in both the quantities numerator is a similar, but here in the first quantity denominator is a big one and this denominator is smaller. If the denominator is a big one, then this total quantity is less. So this is less than equal to, so this one greater than equal to. So on the right hand side, the greater quantity than this, the greater quantity, this is a this one, and greater quantity than this is a this one, and again the greater quantity this one is a mod Zn minus Yn upon 1 plus mod of Xn minus Zn. So if I write here greater quantity on right hand side, आता राइट हैंड साइड मध्ये ह्या फर्स्ट टर्म ही आहे, ह्याच्यापेक्षा ग्रेटर क्वांटिटी जर आपण लिहिली तर राइट हैंड साइड मोठी होईल. दिस इज लेस देन इक्वल टू मॉड एक्सएन माइनस जेडीएन अपॉन 1 प्लस मॉड एक्सएन माइनस जेडीएन प्लस, आणि राइट हैंड साइडची अगोदरची सेकंड क्वांटिटी त्याच्यापेक्षा ग्रेटर क्वांटिटी जर आपण लिहिली तर राइट हैंड साइड ग्रेटर होईल, मॉड जेडीएन माइनस वायएन अपॉन 1 प्लस मॉड Zn minus Yn. And so now we have this inequality. So I write this inequality here. Now our left hand side is a mod Xn minus Yn divided by 1 plus our left hand side mod Xn minus Yn divided by 1 plus mod xn minus yn. Now here this this our obtained inequality, and now just multiplying both sides by 1 upon 2 to the power n and summing means that is taking summation on both sides, summing both sides means that is taking summation from n is equal to 1 to infinity on both sides. So this term is a we are multiplying by 1 by 2 to the power n, summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon 2 raised to n. Similarly here summation n is equal to 1 to infinity and we are multiplying by 1 by 2 to the power n. Again here for this term plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon 2 raised to n. So now by the definition of this function, so the left hand side is nothing but difference is a difference between xn minus yn. So this left hand side is a distance between xy is less than equal to xn minus zn, means distance between xz plus zn minus yn means distance between zy. So as we have proved here triangle inequality also. So for this function all the four conditions in the definition of metric are proved. So that's why the given function is a metric on x, and that's why the x, that is set of all sequences of complex numbers, is a metric space. And this metric space is a said to be Fréchet space.